and welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather, and I made it. And I actually had the intro ready this time. I hope you heard the music. We have got some fun art journaling going on today, and a lot of folks are already in the audience ready to watch and hang out with us. But my favorite person of all time is the one who's sitting here with me doing it all together. Can you say hello, Sylvia?
Hi, everybody. I'm so glad everybody's here to join us today. I just want to say a shout out to Nanette, Tina, Sandra, Zusa. Zusa, we're so glad you're back. Oh, my gosh, we've missed you so much. Beth, Patty, Jazzy, Shell, Clemencia, it's been a long time for you too. Orla, and Anamati. Thanks for joining us, everybody.
Yes, and in case you can't tell, poor Sylvia, she's struggling with that voice, but she refused to take this time off. She said she had to be here. So thank you, Sylvia. We appreciate you joining us, and we are very glad to have you. Everybody, healing prayers for Sylvia. Get better.
Thank you.
All right, so we have a couple of things that I want to share with you before we get started, and the first one is that I have created a document for the shows, and I talked a little bit about this in the newsletter that you got on Friday. And for those of you who don't have our newsletter, you can do that by going to kraaftit.com/subscribe. And when you subscribe to our newsletter, you get a weekly newsletter and a once a month newsletter that has everything going on in the Kraaft Shaak completely and totally. And the weekly one is usually just a little video vlog of me rambling, and then the blog posts that we've put out that week. So it's a really great way to stay in touch and to get those reminders and all of those things that you're looking for when you're wondering, where's the show? What's going on? How come we're not doing Monday meanderings? And all of those fun things that I keep getting questions about. If you go to kraaftshaak.com/subscribe, then you can get our newsletter delivered right to your inbox. And I think it makes life simpler. What do you think, Sylvia?
I think it's a great, yes, I love it. I love getting it. I like getting my little ping when I get notified that it's in my inbox too, so, yeah.
And I pay her to say that, everybody. Okay, so so that's pretty much what I wanted to share with you, and then we do have a document that does kind of tell you a little bit about what I'm going to be doing today, and in there, in that document that I put into the comments here, if you're watching us live, and if you're watching the recording, then it's down below the video. And all of that information hopefully will help you be prepared for each of the shows. And I've got something really cool for next week. The This and That Thursday video is going to be all about preparing for next week's episode and working on a wooden canvas. So these are all the things that you get when you subscribe. You'll be able to see those things. I also make sure that I put them into the description of the video and all that kind of stuff too ahead of time. So hopefully you're finding them. If you're still having trouble finding them, just let me know and I will direct you in the way that they go. All right, so enough of that junk. Do you want to share with us today's message, and I will get the camera set up? Okay, I'm going to put the camera on you then.
Very happy to share that. And it's a great message too. Today's message: put the storms of life into the hands of Jesus. Even the winds and the waves obey him. Matthew 8:27. I just think that is a fantastic message because it's oh so true. Just give it over to him. And I want to do another shout out to Michael Daniels has joined us today. And we've got Beth Brown and Claret Bell. And okay, those are the newbies that just came in. So we've got 14 people coming in now.
Awesome. Well, welcome, everybody. We're glad you're here. And for those of you who joined us late, we do have a document in the comments there that you can check out exactly what we're doing today. And the reason why I'm mentioning it so much is because the Pinterest board that I reference while I'm in that document, I'm referencing a Pinterest board that I've created where I tend to pin things that inspire me to do the show. And you might find a whole bunch of moon pictures there today. And the reason why is because that's what we're working on in our art journal. So I did do one little piece of preparation so that way we could start with a dry surface right off the bat. And I want to tell you about this just a little bit before I get into it. I'm trying to fit it. This is my large dilutions journal, which we do sell the large and the small here at the store. And I love this journal. It's so fun to take with me everywhere. But one of the cool things I love about journaling is that it doesn't have to be in a prepared journal like this. I know, Sylvia, you've done a ton of those junk journals, and you've made journals out of everything, jelly plates, your mail, the junk mail, especially around election time.
Election time. Oh, my gosh. That's the only good purpose that stuff serves.
I have to agree. So what was really cool was that when I took to art journaling, I didn't have the money to buy a journal. So I used old books. And one of the old books that I did was a gigantic, discarded from the library, World Atlas. And this World Atlas, you might have seen me work in it before, is so large it barely fits on my countertop here. And I love that book, but it's too big to really do a live show justice because it's just so hard to get it in frame. But when I was going through those pages and deciding, you know, which ones I was going to glue together and everything to have my surface to work on, I found some of the pages to be very exciting, like this gigantic moon that I cut out from a couple of the pages. You can see here, this is the this right here is the split from the spine of the book. So it was actually all on one, this much was all on one side and this much was on the second page, and this is where the center of the book was. And I cut it out and I saved it. I've saved it for almost a year now, or a little over a year now. And this particular thing that I've been wanting to do in my art journal has taken me this long to really be okay with doing it live. Sometimes when I'm working in my art journal, I don't really want to share with you guys what I'm doing. Sometimes it's just me getting my frustrations out. And I'm going to let you in on a little secret. I don't always like what I do. Sometimes I just get angry at the page and I do stuff to it. So let me just show you that. This is one of those pages. It looks so funny to me because I was so mad and all I wanted to do was throw art products at the page, and that's what I did. So I played with stamping. I played with, I think these were Neo colors, and I was trying to mess with them with a different brush, and then I got mad and I just started scribbling, and then Carly came in and she helped me and she scribbled and she stamped and we had some fun with it. But that's sometimes what happens in my art journal. I don't care.
That looks like my normal art journal page.
So funny. But I mean, there's just lots of things that I've done. Here's another one where I just offloaded one of the brushes that I was using. I think it was actually an applicator. And I just offloaded the applicator onto the pages in no way, shape, or form around a doodle that I had done. So I just want you to see that art journaling isn't a perfect science, and it certainly isn't something that has to be a completed spread. Sometimes I just doodle randomly. This one was done like 4 or 5 days. While I was on vacation in Arizona, I just sat there and drew while other people watched TV, and then you've seen me do some of these ones before. So anyway, I just wanted you to see that it's not every single page isn't perfect, and sometimes they have meaning and sometimes they don't. And this one I'm hoping will have some meaning. So I started by using soft matte gel, and I'm down to this. This is all I have left of soft
matte. Is that all that's left?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh.
And it's not much. Look at this.
Oh, wow.
I'm probably going to use it all up today. So yeah, I need to place an order, and they need to have it in stock. Anyway, okay, so what I did was just put that thin layer down underneath and glued it on, and it is stuck there. I did kind of go over some of the edges a little bit, but I don't really care too much because we're going to be using gesso over the top of this. So
that is such
ahead.
A beautiful picture of that moon. I just love it. And
Isn't it
actually
awesome?
Looks so dimensional, too.
I know. Isn't it awesome? I loved it.
And I just want to let you know, Heather, that we have Cece with us.
Cece's here. Everybody say hi to Cece. Everybody.
Oh, everybody's been saying hi to Cece.
Of course. She's our resident celeb.
And Beth Brown has joined us again today also.
Awesome. Glad to see you, Beth, because I know you had said you weren't going to be able to make it live today. So really glad to have you live. I'm glad to have all of you live because dead just doesn't work for me. I know that you have to laugh, Sylvia, otherwise my jokes fall flat, okay? It's really lame. Okay, so this is the art journal page. I've cut off my moon and I'm ready to go with it now. Now, I had thought originally I was going to do it more, you know, the top towards the bottom like this. I was going to do it more like this way. That is originally what I had planned to do, but I decided to save this for another piece, so I might do that one. So see, I got like two out of one. Anyway, okay, so let's get some gesso out. Now, for those of you wondering what I'm using today, I tried to put as much of it as I could into that document because I don't know where we're going. It's our journal exploration. We don't have any rules. I did pull out a couple of other items that are not on the list, like these scrap letters from Doodlebug that I have, a couple of stamp sets I may or may not use with lettering, just so that way I've got them. And everything else I think I put it on there. So we've got distress paints, we've got gelatos, we've got heavy body acrylic paints. I don't know what we're gonna play with. We'll see. Okay, now I did tell you about my intentions to use the Pinterest board as an inspiration, right? I already talked about that.
Yeah, and I put the link in the comments here too.
Awesome. So for those of you who check out that Pinterest board, now I'm going over this entire page while we're talking with just a wash of gesso. And I'm not actually watering it down. I'm just going to spread it out, and I don't like this brush for this. So let me use up this gesso on here and get a different brush. So for those of you checking that out, what I wanted you to know about the Pinterest board is that I use Pinterest as an inspiration and menu builder all the time. And one of the things that I have found is that if I go through and pin a bunch of things that I think will work for, you know, whatever image I have in my head, that I don't always use them, but I like having them at my fingertips, and maybe even just seeing it once is enough. So anyway, you can kind of see one of the first images there, which ended up being one of my last images that I pinned, is kind of where this whole thing is going to go. So now, as I said, this is just going to be a gesso wash. I'm not using any water, but I am putting on a very thin layer. So it's less of a wash, more of a thin layer. I still want to see that moon and all of its craters, but I don't want it to be as blue as it is, because we're going to do something totally different. That looks pretty good. Just used a sponge brush because I can throw these away if I want to. And I want to, so that's what I'm doing there. Okay. I've got my tray here of all my goodies. I think I'm going to use some blue, some night. This is heavy body acrylic paint from Dina Wakely. You know, I love this stuff. So I'm going to use night, sky, and blackberry violet. And I'm just going to put it little blobs right here on my, you can't see it, on my freezer paper.
Oh, Andrew and Michael are up to it again.
All right, well, tell me more.
Michael put this comment in. Coming up. Doodlebug, gesso, distress paints. This sounds like a French cast of a movie. And then, of course, Andrew has to say the French disconnection.
Well, that is what we do around here pretty much, yeah. The French disconnection. I love it.
All right,
so I have just, make sure I'm on frame.
Yeah, you
there.
Are. Yeah.
Okay. I have just played with some of the night, a teensy bit of that blackberry violet, and some sky. And I want variation, so I'm not really mixing them. I'm just grabbing them and putting them on top of my brush. And then I'm just going to go in here and go the other direction with some of this. So we get some variation in this night sky. And the lighter around the moon is perfect. We want that. And you know what? I think I just want to use a different brush. Totally. I don't like how that's working out. That one brush is not my friend tonight. Today, whatever. So, yeah, this is what I would rather it be. Pull some of that away. The problem with these sponge brushes is that you have to use a little bit more paint in order to get the color to come out onto the page, but such is life.
Yeah, they're thirsty. They eat a lot.
Yeah, they do. That's very true. All right. Now, notice that I'm not really worried too much about the moon, about getting it on the moon or causing any dilemmas there. Especially around the bottom, because I think we're going to be putting I can't paint and talk at the same time. That's obvious. Spaceships, yes, I'm going to put space. No, that wasn't my intention anyway. It may end up looking like spaceships. All right.
That's such the reason a pretty why. Color,
oh, go ahead. You know? Sorry, didn't hear you.
It's a very pretty color.
Yeah, I like that it's got, let's put a little bit more night in. Over here on the right side. I like that it's got all these different variations. So you're seeing the blue and the purple and then that really dark blue.
Yeah.
That's what that night color is, a very big dark blue there.
I'm going to put this up where you're sponging that around. This is from Cece. Okay. Sponge brushes are the vampires of the art world. They are thirsty creatures. Yes, they are.
Yes, I totally agree.
And then I hate washing them out because you wash all that paint out.
Yep, I totally agree. Totally agree. I do like using them for a large application like this because I didn't want it to be perfect for sure. And that other brush is going to take us forever. Okay, so here's the night going on. I kind of like that there's some whiteness to it on the back there.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, that shouldn't take too long to dry because really most of the paint's on the sponge than it is on the paper. So, should be good. Distress paint. So, let's go with I'm trying to decide if I want to go with this. A little bit of that. All right. So now my inspiration picture has all of the bright is over on the left as opposed to the right, which we're looking at here. The way that they did this picture, this is the lit part of the moon and that this is the dark side of the moon. But when I'm looking at my Pinspiration board, I'm seeing all the light side is over here and all the dark is over here. I don't really care about that so much. I'm not even caring about whether this makes any sense to anybody because this to me is just going to be about the message that I want to add to it. So using my distress paints, because I just love how these mix with each other, I'm going to dabble on quite a bit of this much lighter yellow. What's the name of this one color? It's called Squeeze Lemonade. And this is fairly dry. It's still wet down at the bottom here, but.
And Andrew said, you know, when you made your remark that it shouldn't take too long to dry, he goes, shouldn't take too long. Where have I heard that before?
Yeah, I know. Typical Heather, right? Okay. A lot more of this there. And then a little bit of this orange. This one's spice marmalade. What was the one? Mustard seed was the second color I used. All right. Now, I know that these colors very much more sun than moon. But if you look at the Pinspiration for this, it's definitely reflecting the sun. And when you see the message, when I'm all done, you'll really understand it all. All right, wet baby wipe. Here we go. And just light circular motions to spread that around. I like variation of color in here. What's going on?
Oh, Andrew's just saying, oh, daisies and sunflowers on the moon. I love it.
It's my art journal and I can put whatever I want on my moon. Seriously, it's my favorite part about an art journal is there are no rules. And I was watching a video not too long ago where someone was talking about, you know, what you can and cannot do in an art journal, and I laughed. I was laughing through the whole YouTube video because I thought, wow, I broke all those rules already. I didn't even know that there were any. Okay, so now I'm just bringing back some of that image again because I do want to see some of those craters still. Not all of them, though.
And Cece's concurring with you on that one, that there are no rules.
That's right. There are no rules. Well, I knew she would agree because it wasn't her video that said that. It's funny. I suppose I should say, for those of you who don't know, Cece is an incredible YouTube artist. She's got great videos showing how to do 90% of everything that I've ever learned because I watch everything she does. But if you don't know, where have you been, I guess? But I don't think there's anybody who doesn't know her. Maybe Andrew. Maybe Michael. All right, okay. Kick off too much there so the words are coming through, and I don't like that.
Proper introduction. Andrew and Michael meet Cece. Cece meet Andrew and Michael.
There you go.
There you go. Now they know each other. You're welcome.
You're always so good at that. All right, and now I've just gone into using my fingers because, you know what, they're just better. All right, I'm liking that.
Nice comment from Orla. I'd like to put this up. Okay. She says, that is why I love Heather, as she is great to tell us it's okay to break the rules in journaling. And that's so true.
Well, thanks. Yeah. And I really feel like when we put limits on ourselves, especially limits like you can't do this or whatever it is, not just art journaling, but anything, you're just putting yourself in a box. And who wants to be in a box? I watched a Criminal Minds last night where the kid was put into a box. It didn't seem like fun at all. So I had to actually shut it off. I couldn't take it anymore. It might have been causing my nightmares even. I don't know. All right. So now I'm going to use that night again because I want a really dark, I don't want black, but I do want a dark silhouette at the bottom down here. And I'm using the sponge because it's dirty. So basically, are you dry yet? Let's see. You need to dry. Just be dry enough so I can play, please. Basically, I want to put a mountain down here that peeks over some of this. It's in front of this this moon here. And maybe it even has some trees at the top of it, so it's not perfectly straight or anything. There, that vampire sucked up all of my paint. I like that she said that. That's a good one. I'm stealing that, obviously, Cece. Wouldn't you guys like to have Cece on air with us? Wouldn't that be so cool to have her do a live show?
I think that'd be awesome.
Now, if I hadn't already asked her to do that, I would never have said that live, but I'm just saying, wouldn't that be cool? You guys need to convince her that she needs to say yes.
Okay, put comments in, people.
All right, let's see. I think this needs to be just a bit bigger here.
You should have your lady on the mountain on that then, too.
Well, you're kind of going to see that. She's talking about here in Butte, we have a 90-foot tall statue of what they call the Lady of the Rockies. She stands at the East Ridge, which is the continental divide that overlooks the entire city. She's kind of our guardian angel, if you will. All right, how's that looking? How's that looking? I'm liking that. I think it needs to be a little taller over here, though.
Yeah. Okay, everybody's putting yes, CC, live. Yes, that would be awesome. Yes, 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 please.
All right, so see, it's not just me, CC. You've got to do it. Okay, I think that is it for my mountain, I think. Just wanted to have the impression there that there is some ground. And now, let's see, where did I put that tray? Okay, so now here, let's talk about something that I had struggled with that you, we're gonna set this aside while it dries. I have an inkjet printer that is a top-loading inkjet printer. So inkjet is its own problems, but then top-loading is another issue. And I struggled with getting images printed onto tissue paper. And I think I may have thrown away, no, here. So this is what happened. Can you see this tissue paper? I followed the instructions on one blog post to print, and I followed it, and I cut it smaller than the copier paper, and I taped it on, and then it almost broke my machine. So if you have a top loading, I did put a blog post in there that'll tell you exactly how to do it. So in that document, so if you don't catch all of these instructions, it's on there. But basically you want to make the paper, tissue paper, bigger than your copier paper and wrap it around to the back. Careful not to make the corners too bulky. So it shows you, you know, how to trim the corners so that way it's not too bulky, and then tape that down really well on the back. Then when you feed it through, success. So my tissue image is now ready to be applied, and here's how we're going to do it. And since I had only used this corner, I went ahead and fed it through the other way and printed out this one, and we'll use that one on maybe next week's episode. I don't know. We'll see. So here is my tissued image. And I don't have to cut this out perfectly, which makes me very happy because tissue paper is going to blend into the background really nice. So it's even better if you tear it, because then those edges will just disappear.
Yeah, yeah, the edges. It's but, like Shell did with her tag, where she did it on deli paper.
I saw that. I was reading her blog post last night and going, how does she know? How does she know what I'm going to do tomorrow?
How'd she know?
She's so smart. Okay, so then here's what I did. I printed the same thing on hymnal paper because I thought, oh, that is kind of cool. Hymnal paper is only a tiny bit thicker than tissue paper. So it was kind of the same concept, but I just made sure that I taped those edges real good. I don't know if you can see that, but I taped the edges real good so that they would not get caught in the top feeding printer. Okay, so here's our image on tissue paper. And are you dry yet?
Let's see. I like that image.
All right, and I want her to be standing on the mountain, basically, and looking up like that. I think that's how we're gonna do it. But it's not dry. So dry already. We'll just... Today's show is brought to you by the Heat Tool from Ranger. Available now at the craftshack.com store. I got to work on that, obviously.
Well, everybody was so excited about Cece being on the show, and she said, okay, you guys, I'm blushing so hard here. I'm heating up my whole studio.
That is awesome. That is awesome. Yeah, we really do have to talk about it, Cece, because I think that it would be really great to have you on and have you do something for us. That's all I'm going to say. I had an idea there, but I won't say it out loud. Not now.
And Shell said that she says we're twins of like minds, I think, Heather.
I think so too, 80s rocking girl. When we got to hang out with her, it was just so funny how we're both singing the songs and.
Well, they're bopping around. They're sitting down and they're journaling. They're working on the canvases that we did, and their heads are bopping and they're singing and they're having a good time.
All right. I think that's how that's going to go, I think. I don't really like these. I think these things down here are messing with where I want them to go. So we're going to cut those off. Give that a little bit more time to dry, too. So, yeah, that's my reasoning. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. We don't really need shadows and stuff. This is...
No.
Oh. Also, in the document, I did tell you where I got this image. So if you're looking for other silhouettes, there are a whole bunch of silhouettes available in that clip art, silhouette clip art. And I did link to this there. That's going to be better. Okay. My little teensy weensy bit of gel. Here we go. And I'm using the same brush that I was using before, so I have to dry it off. I just had it sitting in water. So here we go. Wish me luck or whatever.
Luck.
Is everybody holding their breath or is it just me? Okay,
here we go. Not everybody's holding their breath.
All right. Okay, so there we go. Over the top of that. A little bit under and a little bit over. And hopefully it'll all be stuck down and you won't see the edges. That's my hope. And I think it's going okay thus far. And I might need to touch up some spots where it's not as see-through as I wanted it to be, but that's okay. It might also be because it's wet too, so I might have to have patience. All righty. Okay, so the patience is going to come while I ignore how white that is, because you can see that, right? Can't you see that?
Yeah.
See how white that is? I'm going to ignore that, put the lid on. Oh, I still have a teensy bit more. Yay me. And we're going to move on to the words. So I'm actually going to put this out of sight, because I think that will help me not mess with it. What did I do? Okay, so I've got my little doodlebug stickers, and I wonder, I was going to color them, but now that I'm looking at the color scheme, I don't know how much color I can really give these and them still show up. Let's see. Just do what I do and ignore her for a little bit, okay? I was going to color them. What do you guys think? Should I color these?
Okay, everybody, what do you think? What color were you going to go with, Heather?
Well, I was going to do like a really bright blue or turquoise, but I don't know that that's going to...
Okay, everybody, what do you think? Should she color them or leave them white?
Hmm. Let's see. Let's just put him down a little bit and we'll see. So here's
Shell's going orange.
Orange, really?
Orange. Okay. And Beth Brown says, I like the white. Sandra says, I like the white.
All right. All right. Here, I'm putting them out as their words are coming in. I'm putting them out.
Cece's going turquoise. Nanette, Christian said, leave it white. Nanette, light white or dark blue. Andrew, go with white. Patty, white. I like them white from Orla. Or purple. Right. That's from Patty. Of course, it'd be purple.
Yeah, of course, she'd choose purple. Well, purple's not going to work today, Patty. I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, this part of this really, really wigs me out, okay? When I look at this font, I always think that at this point with the S, they flipped it upside down.
Yeah.
Don't you think it looks better like this than it does like that?
Yeah, and I don't like the T either. I think the T isn't, yeah. Mm-hmm. Patty's going, oh, shucks.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to put this. This is going to go in the purple, so maybe white is better. These are not totally stuck down, so if we change our mind, we change our mind.
And then CC said red, and then Shell says blue and or orange are complementary colors, so they would pop out.
Okay, so here's where it's going, and then I'm thinking I'm just going to do black for the other words. I think.
Andrew says white with purple beveled edges.
Oh, brother.
And Andrew's going bright orange.
typical. Okay. I don't know which of these letters I want to use either. The four letter sets that I have going on over here. Let's use them all. All right. When you can't decide, just use them all. That's the way I'm going to play this one. All right.
I like to mix them up. Yeah.
The E really wanted to come off already. Okay, that's a good sign. All right. So I've got some archival because we don't know if we're done doing anything to this yet or not. Should we have After Crafter today, do you think? Anybody who wants to join us?
What do you say, everybody? You want to do an After Crafter?
This show is all about you guys, so you just let us know in the comments if you'd like to join the After Crafter party. For those that don't know, that just means you stay and you hang out. After the broadcast ends, we'll invite you up. And if you've got a webcam, you can interact and mingle with us. If you don't have a webcam, that's fine, just as long as you have something that you can talk to us with. Would work great. And if you don't have that either, you can still chat in the typing just like you're doing now. But you do have to stick around and then accept the invite and come in with us. So you know what? I'm doing this backwards. Let me put this one aside for a minute. I think I want to do this. Let's start with the. I was too busy yakking and forgot what I was doing. That never happens. Here's the fun about doing this kind of stuff is that it's so not scripted that it just is whatever it's going to be. And I like that. Some people this intimidates, but I like that. We don't really have a set expectation. Okay, I think I'm married to the white, so we're just going to stick with that, and who knows, I may outline it or something. For now, that's what we're sticking with, so I'm pushing those down. And I'm putting the...
That's a cute font. I like that font.
Yeah, and what is this one? It's from Close to My Heart, and it was, it looks like it was a stamp of the month from last July. Sorry about that if you're looking for it. Just see if you could find it on eBay or something. I don't know. There's so many things out there nowadays that you can find something similar. You don't have to have this exact one. Oh. There we go. Okay, so moving right along. Anybody saying anything out there? Or are they just so mesmerized by my ridiculous stamping?
I'm typing AKP, so we've got some AKP.
Good.
Yeah. And Cece gives her apologies. She says she'd like to, but she has to leave at 3.
Well, that's totally fine. You don't have to stick around at 3. Oh, that's right. She's. I forget about the time zone difference. I'm like, 3? Oh, my gosh, I'm late. Okay, phew. That was close. I, too, have to be somewhere at 3. I'm going to get my driver's license renewed. I forgot to do it before the birthday. Shame on me. All right, so these are the upper class. No, these are the upper case letters of that same font.
Cool.
And still using black because I want to. And no one has said differently. I think black is good. Black and white will be great for this, I think. Okay, and now the B. All right, so there is our first part of our phrase.
And did you see this phrase someplace, Heather, or is this something you've had in your mind?
It's something I've had in my mind, and I tried looking it up to see if I could find where I may have gotten it from, and I can't find it anywhere. So if somebody else out there knows where I may have gotten it from, let me know. It's something that's been going on in my mind pretty much all year, and what I'm trying really hard to focus my energies on. I need a bigger block. That one's not going to work for this other word. And I've got to get all these words out before I start stamping, because if I don't, I won't know where the placement is going to be. Especially because I'm not going to be able to use all these letters in one stamp. So, oh, fun. When I first started, being a consultant for Close to My Heart, which was a long time ago. And as you know, I don't do that anymore, but I thought that I would have to purchase multiples of these letter stamps, these alphabet stamps, because I thought, how else are you going to spell out the words? But then I learned how to do this. I know, it's funny, right? Okay, because I have a problem with spelling, not that you've ever seen me misspell anything on this show, ever, I need to make sure I do this right. Okay, yeah, okay, good. All right, so that's going to go there, so we'll just go ahead and stamp that part. Sure we will. I need to re-ink this pad. Obviously, because it's not ink. Get on there. Don't touch that. Remember our motto, you know, fun is to be had and mistakes are bound to happen. Sometimes I make things happen. Not on purpose. All right, we'll fill that in with a pen. Boy, I better be spelling this right. I'm going to really be upset with myself if I get it wrong. I'm not even looking it up, though. We're going with it. Have faith.
Just go with it. That's right.
Have faith in my inabilities to spell. Has anybody else out there ever misspelled anything?
Oh, gosh, I don't know. I just watched a video the other day, you know, be original. Is that what it was?
Oh, that's funny. I wasn't even thinking about that, but yeah, yeah. We love you, Cece. That's awesome. I wasn't even thinking about that one. I was thinking about Michael. Michael's always being teased about it. His spelling or lack thereof. When we play game show, it's always, well, that can't be that word because there's no way Michael could spell it. So. This better be how you spell it. I'm done. I'm married to it right now. There we go. Boom. Okay. Yeah, that one I'm going to have to fix. I'll fix it in post. Don't you worry about a thing. Okay. I've got these ones to go down here, so let's not do them upside down, though. I think that would be bad. I could have done this whole thing with these little block letters like this, but hello, three-letter word, and it's taken me an hour. And then I need the three-letter word. I can handle 2 3-letter words with these things, but that's about it.
While you're sorting that out, I'm going to put Andrew's comment up.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
I've never misspelled anything, but I've done it to a lot of other words. Got 2 D's in words.
Right, because anything is easy to spell. It's the other words that are difficult.
That's right.
Okay, before I put that onto my picture, let's wipe off my hands too, because I'm making a mess here. I don't get messy when I art. No, not at all.
Well, Cece puts that stuff on her hands.
I know. I need some of that stuff. It's like art guard or something.
Yeah.
I don't think it would help me because I would forget to put the art guard on my hands, I think. I think it would be a nice little dish of stuff that would sit forever and ever unused, I think. I'm just guessing. Knowing me.
I kind of like getting my fingernails all cruddy and my hands all cruddy and everything.
Yeah, I don't really have a choice because I better like it because I do it all the time. Okay, so here we go. This is dry over here, and yet it still didn't disappear the way I thought it would. So I'll just go over it with more of that night.
Perfect. Paint. And CCC, yes, it's called Art Guard.
I knew it. See, I pay attention to those videos. I do. All right. Now I'm using the chiseled edge of my brush sponge or whatever the heck this thing is called to give the impression of some trees back there. And
then Christian says liquid glove works great too.
Ooh, is that like the same thing or a different manufacturer or is it something totally different? I could be here all day doing this because I like it. Okay. There we go. Can you see it now without the glare? Is that a little better? Did I disappear? Oh, no, you're muted. Okay.
Good. Yeah.
No panic attack or anything. Not that I've, you know, ever freaked out about the live feed going away. All right. Just going to add a little bit more because it's still pretty transparent here.
Yeah, like
all right.
That.
So that's that. I think that I just have a little bit of doctoring to do to the letters and stuff. And we still have time. I can do them, huh?
Do you think? Yeah, we got a few minutes, yes.
You know what? I think I actually want to add some paint here, too, because I don't... Yeah. Yeah, now we're talking. Make that disappear into the background a little bit. Thank you. Yeah, that's better. It's much better to use the baby wipe for this application, I think. I like the way that is working there. What do you think that? Does that?
That's really good. That helped disguise that real good. It looks great. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to grab a Posca pen or something. Yeah, Posca pens, because you know I love those things. What else should I get? How about my Stabilo All pencils? Will those help too? I don't know if there's any water in that or not. Let's see. I just grabbed everything. This one's a little crooked, this R. We don't care, do we?
No.
I know I don't.
It's actually due to the reflection of the heat waves from the earth, you know?
Yeah. Exactly, you know exactly. Yeah. Yeah. Make up whatever story makes you feel better.
Christian was asking, where did you find the moon image?
Oh,
she was here in the beginning.
Oh. Right, right. So I use old books for my art journals, and one of the old books that I used, not this art journal, but the art journals that I used before I was able to buy one of these journals, which I love them very much. But anyway, I used an old world atlas that had been discarded by the library. And this, it's a huge book. It's so big you can't really put it on screen. And it had this gigantic moon in there, so I cut that out. It has a whole lot of stuff in there, lots of big map pages. And I used a lot of the pages, glued them together to make more stable pages so that way I could art journal on them. But then a few of them I pulled out, like this one, and just cut out. And I actually had actually cut out the words from that page too, like moon and lunar and eclipse, and just different words that were pretty large that would have been great in our journal. I might use those on the other part, because remember I have this other piece too. I have this, which is portion that I cut off, so I can use that for another one. You know, and you don't have to have a moon image. You can draw the moon. It's just a big circle, right? So it is kind of cool. It has all these craters on it. It's like a map of the moon. It's the Atlas of the Moon. Weird. I haven't found another atlas that has those in it since. I could be here all day doing this. It's very therapeutic. Has anybody looked up the word to make sure I spelled it right? Because no, I mean, I don't care. I'm not going to change it, but I just wondered. And if this is your first time watching us live, we really do appreciate you being here. And those of you watching in the replay, join us for a live show once. See if you can make it. We're a nice bunch. We don't bite or anything, usually. I think I'm going to have to put some highlights on these letters, too, so they pop out. What do you think?
Yeah.
All the silence. The silence doesn't make me nervous, not at all.
I'm sorry. I just have to been muting myself because I'm in a coughing
spell
right now. So I'm sorry.
Oh, you're in it right now. Okay, don't talk. All right. So then I will do all the talking, which may make people tune out. Poor Sylvia, you guys. I like how the little typed letters kind of go wherever they want. I like that about them. All right, I think that's good enough for now. I don't want to put my hand in this, so I'm not going to mess with those up there too much. I think I might do some reflections on these just so that way these will stand out over here. So we'll just put a white line down each one of these. And I'm not waiting. I love Posca pens for this reason right here. And that's still wet. Okay, fine. I'll get the heat tool. Jeez. Today's show is brought to you by the Ranger Heat Tool. Yeah, let's go with that. I think these guys need something too, like maybe a little bit of reflection underneath them or something. I don't know. Maybe we'll do this.
Yeah, a shadow. You know, you got the moon shadow there. So.
Exactly. That's what we're telling ourselves anyway. I can go overboard with that sometimes, so I have to be careful. Like right there, I think that one, it doesn't belong. Baby wipe to the rescue. Bye-bye now.
Excellent.
Bye-bye now, just like that. Bye-bye now.
Yeah, I have to agree with Nanette. She said, beautiful page, so inspirational. It is. I just love her arms outstretched like that. It's just taking in all the glory. I just love it.
Me too. I really looked for something that represented my all. That's kind of what I was thinking when I was looking for this picture was, I want to give my all. How do I give my all? How do I represent visually giving my all? And that's what that is to me. Thank you, baby wipe, for making
good
a mess.
Job.
Okay, there we go. I should probably zoom in at this point, but then you'd really see my mistake, so I don't want to do that. I'm going to go back in after it's dry, I think, and wipe off those parts on the white letters where I just added a little too much shadow.
Okay, so for AKP, I've got Tina Anamari, Nanette, Jazzy, Beth Brown. Anybody else want in? Claret, are you going to join us?
You're all welcome.
Christian. So if I missed anybody, let me know in the comment, please.
And if you can't make it, we understand. Not, it's certainly not a requirement. We don't even frown upon it or anything. We understand.
I just keep a tab record going, people. That's all.
Kidding. Yeah, she does, actually. And then she tells me later, those people matter. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. That was really wrong. Shouldn't have said that. Okay, I think that's it. I think that's it. I think I really like that. Wow, I like that a lot. Okay, here. See if that shows it.
Beautiful. Christian, I have a cold too, and I sound horrible, yet I'm here, so you can come in too.
Yeah, so get in here. I think, maybe does she need a little bit of shadow on her? I think she might. Let's see if I can wreck it. Here we go.
Cece says she has to go. She loves your page. It looks amazing.
Love you, Cece. We'll talk to you later. Thanks, everybody, for joining. And those of you who have to leave, I understand lunchtime is just about over. Tina, if you have to go, I got it.
Michael says he's not allowed to attend a party before 5 p.m. So,
well, and that's really a good thing if you know Michael at all, because he's kind of wild. So it's best for all of us, really.
Okay. I convinced Christian she has to come in.
Yay. All right. I think I'm done. I don't know what the heck happened there. I think I didn't cover it with
Bye, CC.
Bye. All right, gang. I think that's it. I think I've done all the damage I can do to this page. Just got to put my moniker on it over here. Let's do this one over here. All right, there's our page.
Beautiful.
And we'll see you in the After Crafter party. And if you haven't done so yet, you can register for next week's show. And of course, there's going to be a document that will go out probably today, tomorrow, somewhere in there. And I think that's everything. Let's just say goodbye.
Sounds great. Goodbye, everybody. Thanks for joining us.
Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.